Good morning. Welcome to our worship service this morning. If you're joining us from home live or this afternoon or 3 days from now, we are so glad to have you with us. We are worshiping this morning from our Book of Alternative Services, page 47, which is morning prayer. If you are watching on our live feed, and it will be included on our YouTube video later, there is a link to a service bulletin if you would like to follow along for ease. We will be including two hymns this morning. One, we're going to sing our psalm, which is hymn number 519, and the link is on your Facebook feed. We will also be singing Come and Journey with a Savior, and unfortunately, those lyrics are not easily found online, so you'll just have to listen and enjoy. We begin on page 47. Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us worship. And we say during the Easter season the Jubilate. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age.
Thank you.
Our first reading is a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. Awe came upon everyone because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all, as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Our second reading comes from the first letter of Peter. For it is a credit to you if, being aware of God, you endure pain while suffering unjustly. If you endure when you are beaten for doing wrong, what credit is that? But if you endure when you do right and suffer for it, you have God's approval. For to do this, you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example so that you should follow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but he entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that free from sins, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed. For you were going astray like sheep, but now you have returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Journey.
Lord be with you. This is a reading of our Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The Gospel of Christ. Our book study continued this week online, and we read Brené Brown's Daring Greatly. She writes early in the book about how she became a shame and empathy researcher, developing a theory that explains in part how we cultivate a resilience in the face of believing that we are not enough, that we're not worthy of love and belonging. Wholeheartedness at its very core is vulnerability and worthiness, she says. Facing uncertainty, exposure, and emotional risks, and knowing that I am enough. Some of us are vulnerability avoidant. And I know you know what that looks like. It's shields up. It's a dance of being with the other person, or what you think or believe the other person needs or wants you to be. It is the belief that we can get around it and still be in deep and meaningful relationship with others. And if you read or watch any of Brené Brown's books or her TED Talks, this is the point when she laughs. And it is the kind of laugh from a woman who knows that that is a lie. She writes, I did believe that I could opt out of feeling vulnerable. I controlled things. I managed situations and micromanaged the people around me. I performed until there was no energy left to feel. I made what was uncertain certain, no matter what the cost. I stayed so busy that the truth of my hurting and my fear could never catch up. I looked brave on the outside and felt scared on the inside. Our gospel reminds us, right out of the figurative gate, that doing that very thing that Brené talks about, trying to enter the gate, to enter the kingdom, or to enter relationships, or to enter into positions of leadership, not authentically, not honestly, not vulnerably through the gate, but in a sense, climbing in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. A thief and a bandit. And what do thieves and bandits do? They skulk, and they hide, and they run, and they lie. Jesus, in describing the Good Shepherd, teaches us what it means to be good. And to be clear, it's not the best shepherd. It's not the better than all the other shepherds. It is good, the Good Shepherd. The good enough, in other words. To be the Good Shepherd is to be honorable. It's to sacrifice his fears, his insecurities, his own shields for the good of the sheep. The sheep know the shepherd because the shepherd is always truly himself, always dependable, always reliable in what the sheep can expect, always aware of the needs of his sheep, and he comes to them through the most direct, the most honorable, honest, and most visible way that he can, right through the gate. He's not sneaking in at night. He's not inching forward little by little. He's not pouncing down in front of them with jazz hands and some kind of show of excitement to distract them. He walks in through the gate and calls them by name. And the sheep follow him because they trust him, because they know him, because he has truly shown himself to them, and they believe him. Just as he is good, that they are also, they believe, good enough and worthy enough to be with him. What we discover through our second reading in Acts is that it is exactly when we are willing to shed our heavy shields and risk letting ourselves be truly and fully known that we too will unleash many wonders and signs. We too will accomplish great things. We will unleash creativity. We will love more deeply, and we will strengthen the communities that we belong to. The people devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers, and great things came of it. Like the sacrificial shepherd, they sell their things and they give where there is need for it because they trust that they have enough. They trust that they are enough. They don't need more. They don't need better than. They are enough. It's been a while since I've thrown a movie quote out at you. If you are watching and you haven't been with us in worship before being online, I use a lot of movie references, a lot of song references, and so from Letters to Juliet. What and if are two words as non-threatening as words can be. But put them together side by side and they have the power to haunt you for the rest of your life. What if? What if? What if? What if we dare to let go of those emotions that strangle and burn us? Fear and shame. Choosing instead to be recklessly courageous and compassionate and the connected people of God that God has created us to be. What if we allow ourselves to be truly seen by others? To lead with vulnerability as our ultimate strength? What if we assume an unlimited confidence in our ability to reap only positive, life-affirming, great things? What if we, boldly and confidently and wrapped in wholeheartedness, walk through the gates and call each other by name? What if? Continuing with our affirmation of faith, we're going to say the Hear, O Israel. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first and the great commandment. The second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. Let us pray. Gathered in the care of the Good Shepherd and guardian of our souls, let us pray for the church and for the world, saying, Lord, have mercy. For all who serve the Holy Church of God, who serve tables and who preach and pray, who shepherd the lost and care for those in need, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who are persecuted for the gospel, for all who have been martyred for their witness to the truth, for all in lonely places who rejoice in the hope of the resurrection, and for the blessed community of the saints, living and dead, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all in the world who care for the sick, the dying, the hungry, and the destitute, those who struggle for mental health and those who battle addiction, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For victims of rage and sudden violence, especially for abused children and spouses, for political prisoners, victims of extortion, of murder, and of natural catastrophe, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. We remember specifically in our prayers this morning Judy and Clifton, David, Kevin, David, Rob, Karen, Janice, Marianne, that we may come to receive abundant life at God's hand, and that at the last to rest in Christ's shepherding love, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who have died, remembering especially this week, Joy Ficco. For all who have suffered loss during this pandemic, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For St. John the Evangelist, Ottawa, and their priest, the Reverend Canon Beth Bretzlaff, and the Reverend Deacon Carolyn Ducrot. For the Anglican Communion in Japan and their clergy. For South Philip Church in Nablus, West Bank in our Companion Diocese of Jerusalem, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. O loving God, we commend to your mercy all who have died and pray that we and all your saints may share life in your eternal dominion. Enable us to know that by Christ's wounds we have been healed, and that by the power of his risen and spirit-giving life, we are empowered to serve you all our days. We pray through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. Our collect appointed for this, the fourth Sunday of Easter, let us pray. O God, whose Son is the Good Shepherd, send us out as shepherds to seek the lost, to heal the injured, and to nurture all with grace and compassion, through Jesus, who calls us each by name. Amen. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And may the one who walks on wounded feet walk with you to the end of the road. The one who serves with wounded hands teach you to serve each other. The one who loves with a wounded heart be your love always. May you see the face of Jesus in everyone you meet. They see the face of Jesus in you. May God's blessing be upon you this day and always. Amen. Stay home and love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.